Dallas Cowboys fans, let's get ready to rumble!
How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Alright, what did I get up to?
We got a job to do, and we're gonna do it, baby!
Happy playoffs, and welcome to How Many, the podcast that counts. I am one of your hosts, Jesse Jackson, and we are here today with another clip show. It's kind of hard to get us all together during the week, but we have everyone, mostly, giving their predictions for this rarity of rares, a second game in a playoff run by your Dallas Cowboys. That's right. Cowboys took care of business against Seattle, and now they are heading to the West Coast where it's sunny and shiny. They're going to play the Rams. What do we think is going to happen? Hang on, and we'll tell you.
Two girls for every boy. I got a 34 wagon and we call it.
Hello, loyal How Many listeners. It's Junior here. And as usual, I've been proven completely wrong with my Cowboy predictions.
Originally, at the beginning of the year, I thought this would be Garrett's final season. We would finish around 8-8. And I just thought overall we were going to have a very unsuccessful season. I was pleasantly surprised to see that we not only won the division, but we ended up winning our first playoff game over this past weekend, beating the Seahawks, which I did predict, even though my recording didn't actually make it into the last How Many podcast. So I'm hoping that the Cowboys will win this coming game versus the Rams in the next round. But my official prediction, all hoping aside, I think that the Rams will beat us this coming Saturday. I predict a score of Rams 31, Cowboys 24. I think we will be able to keep Jared Goff in check. I don't foresee him having a really big game against us. He has struggled over the past couple of games in the regular season, especially against good defenses. He struggled against the Eagles. He struggled against the Bears. But I have a feeling that Todd Gurley is going to have a field day against us. I know our run defense has been good this season, but I just think that Gurley is going to go off for a big game against us. Even though that home crowd in LA is going to probably be split down the middle 50-50 with all the Cowboy fans there, I think Gurley will have a big game and feed off of the 50% of the crowd that belongs to the Rams. And I think that will be the deciding factor. I don't think we'll be able to keep him in check. And I don't think we'll be able to score enough points to keep pace with that Rams offense. So again, Rams 31, Cowboys 24. Even though we lose this game, and I'm hoping we win. But even if we lose, I still say this would be a very successful season for the Cowboys. I don't think very many of us thought they were going to win the division, much less make it to the second round of the playoffs. So I am very, very happy that we've made it this far, and I think this will actually be a good building block for next season. Even though I was kind of hoping all along that not only Garrett would be gone, but Linehan would be gone as well, but this probably punches their tickets for an extension going into next season. So again, good luck to the Cowboys. We're all rooting for them, but I think the season ends on Saturday. And just for some added bonus, here's some karaoke exclusively for the Cowboys.
Dallas Cowboys. We are the Cowboys.
Hello, this is Bob, and I wanted to go over my predictions for this week's playoff games, but also, I guess, briefly touch on what transpired with the Cowboys last week against the Seahawks game last week. Cowboys won, solid, probably should have won by more. Didn't like seeing that late TD get given up. Byron Jones looked terrible on that drive. But all in all, solid win. A lot of Zeke. Dak was steady. And I think that was a good all-around team win. Defense was outstanding most of the game. Like I said, that very end there, Byron Jones really was sparing it up. But I think they do have a shot against the Rams. You know, I'm sure a lot of people maybe think that that's just dead man walking for the Cowboys going in there. But the Rams have not played well the last part of the season, and their defense is kind of overrated. They've got several really good defensive players. You know, Aaron Donald literally is the best defensive player in the league, bar none. It's not even close. But maybe Khalil Mack is somewhat near him, but he's just a badass. So I think that the Cowboys, you know, I predicted the NFC Championship game, so I've got to stick with it. I think it's going to be a close game, and I think it'll probably be where one of those games where both teams are at or near 30. I think the Cowboys are going to have to score, and maybe they'll get a defensive touchdown this weekend to help total it up. But give me Cowboys 30-28. And as far as the other games are concerned, as stupid as it sounds, I know the Saints are way better than the Eagles. And they're at home, and the Eagles, but something tells me that for whatever reason, somehow, some way, the Eagles are going to win that game. They shouldn't. There's no reason they should. Anybody with a brain wouldn't pick them to win, but I'm just playing a hunch on this one. Plus, I wouldn't mind seeing the Cowboys get to host the NFC Championship game. And then over in the AFC, you've got Chargers and the Patriots. I would love the Chargers to win just because I'm sick of the Patriots. It's at New England. I just can't pick against the Patriots at home in the playoffs. So give me the Patriots there. And then in the other game, Chiefs and Colts. I'm telling you right now, the Colts are hotter than any team in the NFL. That blowout shutout of the Cowboys was not a fluke. They took care of business last week at Houston. They're going to beat Kansas City. I know the Chiefs are awesome, Mahomes, the whole nine yards, but nobody's playing better than the Chiefs right now. So give me the Chiefs in that one. So my picks are Chiefs, Patriots, Cowboys, and Eagles. See you next week, boys.
Guess it's my turn to talk about my predictions. At the beginning of the season, I did predict that the Cowboys would do 10-6 and make it to the NFC Championship game. I'm going to stick with that. I think that against the Rams, they are going to find a way to win. I have no idea if this is going to be close or not. My gut tells me it's going to be. Because a long time ago, the late, great Dave Conlin was talking to me when the Rangers had made the playoffs and were playing Tampa, I believe. And it was a tough series. And Dave looked over at me and said, "Jesse, it's the playoffs. It's not supposed to be easy." So as much as I would love to watch the Cowboys just slide all the way, you know, easy win by multiple touchdowns every playoff game, that's not the way it's supposed to be. My prediction is the Cowboys will keep the streak going, will win, and we'll all be back here next week to discuss a third playoff game in this season. Because The boys are back. The boys are back. The boys are back in town.
Each year losing.
And now the part of the podcast you've been waiting for. It's Chris and Colin talking Cowboys.
All right. Second installment. Shout out to Moses podcast.
Shout out to Moses.
Shout out to Moses. Got a shout out to Moses. Second installment, which means Cowboys did actually win a playoff game last week. That was a great game, actually.
I think it was a great game.
We got the Los Angeles Rams this week. It's a Saturday game. Very happy about that. It's going to be a tough one. I actually was a Eagles fan last week because I did not want to play the Saints at their spot this round because they, we kind of embarrassed them earlier this year, and they probably are going to come and want to whoop our butt, you know?
Yeah, the Saints are hot right now. Rams are hot too, but the Rams, I think, are a better matchup for the Cowboys.
Yeah, I think that one of the things they've talked about on the radio is that the since they work out in Oxnard, there's a bunch of Cowboy fans up there in Los Angeles. So, instead of going to the Superdome, where it's going to be loud, it's going to be loud there in the Coliseum, but there's going to be a bunch of Cowboy fans there. So we got a good shot. We're 7-point underdog, though.
Yeah. They got an explosive team. They get a lot of sacks. That's the only thing that's worrying me. They get a lot of sacks. Prescott loves to get sacks.
Yeah, he does.
That's his favorite stat.
He loves to tap the ball three times, four times.
Tap the ball three times.
And then get sacked. Then
crushed and sometimes cough up the ball.
Especially in the red zone. God. See, he has not fumbled in a while. Knock on wood. I hope that. So like we talked about earlier last week, I'm okay if we lose as long as it's not a BS way that we lose. Like, I don't, if we fumble it and they get a easy touchdown, if they just outright beat us because they're better than us, that's going to suck. But, yeah, if we play our game, we keep it close. That's one thing about the Cowboys is that, besides that Colts game, we always are in it every time. It always comes down to the wire.
It needs to be Zeke's game. Just feed Zeke all game. Defense is due for a turnover. If the defense plays tough and we get some turnovers, feed Zeke. That's all we need to do.
He looked good last week, too. Yeah. He looked real good. He looked refreshed. He looked energized. He looked into it. Yeah, we got to use him and use him and use him. And then hopefully Prescott can take us home in the fourth. That's kind of been our MO this whole season, especially during this win streak, is Zeke. A couple passes here and there. Hopefully we can score touchdowns, because if we get field goals with these guys, that's not going to work for these guys. Last week, Seattle's a lot like us, but the Rams are explosive. They've got a great offense. I think Todd Gurley is going to play, but he's been hurt.
Yeah. Well, he's from Georgia, so he's a little bit of sorry, Papa J.
Sorry, JW. Family friendly.
Yeah, but Todd Gurley, they have a good team, man. They have a good squad. Coach is young and wired up. They got Wade Phillips on defense.
Yeah, we got the match of the century, Jason Garrett versus Wade Phillips. Wade's going to want to beat him because, Garrett took his job.
Yeah, I would take Wade in a fight between those two.
Yeah, I think I would too, actually. Yeah. Wade seems like he's a scrapper.
Yeah. He's a scrappy old timer. He's got some tricks. He's got some Dusty Rhodes tricks.
But do you allow tricks?
Yeah, always.
Man, Dusty Rhodes, always. Real quick on a side note, RIP Mean Gene Okerlund.
Yeah, yeah. That was a rough one, man. He was the GOAT of interviews. Who was better on the mic than Mean Gene, man?
Yeah. Let me tell you something, brother.
I said, man.
Yep. Indeed. Moment of silence for Mean Gene.
Indeed.
Indeed. But I don't know. I like the matchup more than the sports guys are talking about right now. I think we're gonna do better than people think. Like you said, we just can't make stupid mistakes. Can't put the ball on the ground. Gotta score
touchdowns.
Yeah. But I think it's gonna be I think the defense is gonna show out this week.
I hope so. I mean, they played really well last week when our offense, because it seems like we always have the same game plan, really conservative, you know, time of possession, and the defense kind of bails us out in the first part of the game, and then the offense starts clicking second half, which is nice. I mean, you want to be a second half team, you know. Hopefully we just don't get down too much to where we have to play catch up, because we're not good at that. We're not good at, you know, if we're down 14-0 and we just got to throw the ball everywhere, it's not a good recipe for success.
Even if they're down 14-0, you can't go away from the game plan. Feed Zeke, man. Yeah. And then once Zeke starts busting 8-yard runs on this defense, because they're giving up 5 yards per run average to other running backs. So, and they haven't seen Zeke. Mm-mm. So, and they haven't played somebody as good as Zeke.
No. And, you know, one of the, they have Seattle in their division. And so, of course, it's division rivalry. But they play them tough, and the Cowboys are just like them. Just like Seattle. Good defense. They run the ball. Quarterback protects the ball. Doesn't turn it over that often. So, I think that we've got a really good shot. I think I would definitely take the Cowboys and those 7 points. I don't think that we're going to lose, if so, by more than seven. That's a pretty huge line, especially. I mean, I know that they're at home. You get 3 for being at home, so that's another 4 points. But I'm telling you, there's going to be a bunch of Cowboy fans up there. I mean, you know, we haven't – I heard this on the ticket. We haven't won a playoff game on the road since 1992. God, now, they – I know, right? Now, they – you know, again, like they said, you know, we mostly were at home because we were that good back in the day. But still, I mean – you know, the last 2 road playoff games were the Dez catch, which that's, you know, that was a good game. But, you know, we couldn't get him off the field at the end of the game, regardless of the Dez catch. And then we played Minnesota in 2009, and I forgot how much of a butt-whooping that was. It was 34-3. God, Tony got sacked like 6 or 7 times that day. Mm-hmm. Oh, so.
Jared Allen.
Yep. Yeah, and then that was when Brett Favre was their quarterback.
That's gross. But what happens if the Eagles beat the Saints?
Then the Cowboys, if the Cowboys were to win 2, then it would be Eagles versus Cowboys, and it would be actually at Jerry World.
Yeah.
So, but that's way down the
road. That would be terrifying, though.
I know.
If they beat the Saints, no matter what happens, whoever we play next is going to be scary.
Yeah, if we can even win this game.
Yeah.
You know, I've been pretty optimistic all week, and I'm pretty optimistic still, but, you know, it's been since 1996, I think. No, 95, January of 96, since we've been in an NFC Championship game. So we were 5 years old. So this would be this is a big game for us and all Cowboy fans that are our age, you know, like Twang and all them, dude. We had never seen any success like that. And so I love it too, because the city's pumped up. Man. Everybody's got a, you know, everybody's got the Cowboy stuff on. And it's a Saturday game too, which is going to be nice. Beautiful. Real nice. Hopefully all the Cowboy fans in LA get all tanked up all day. And so they can just be, you know,
rowdy.
Real rowdy.
But I have seen the Rams play, I think, twice this season. And they're a good team, man. They didn't get here by mistake. They didn't get the first round bye by mistake.
Yeah. You know, I'm really worried about Sean McVay because, yeah, young coach, he's so innovative with offense. He's going to have something for us that we are not going to be ready for. And so hopefully, you know, Chris Richard and Rod Marinelli can, you know, make those adjustments. I think that the biggest key matchup is going to be Zach Martin versus Aaron Donald. Because, like you said, that they're terrible against the run, but they get after the quarterback. They definitely can sack. I think at the beginning of the season, our offensive line was not good really at all. But over the past winning streak, our offensive line has been really good again.
Do you give Colombo that credit?
Yeah, definitely. You know, we give Jerry a lot of crap, but, you know, those that first-round pick for Amari looks great now. And, I mean, the changes to the offensive line, they've made a difference. Even if it was just a new voice, if it's the same scheme, I think what they said is that they dumbed it down. I mean, they made it real simple. I think they were trying to do too much early in the season, and they just kind of
said. They took the rookie out, too.
Yeah, Williams. But he had a good game last week because Sufelia or whatever, he's still, I think, I don't know if it was his eye or something else, but I'm not sure if he's scheduled to play or not. But yeah, I mean, Connor Williams did have a pretty good game. I mean, you know, if we don't know what kind of game he had, that means he had a good game as an offensive lineman.
Yep. Yep.
I think Cowboys win. I'm going to say 24-17. We hold them only to 17 points.
I'm going to go 31-28.
Ooh. Cowboys win?
Yeah. And a lot of scoring.
What about, okay, what would be on the other side? We've got Saints hosting the Eagles. Did you watch any of that Bears game?
I didn't.
The Eagles, no?
I didn't.
You didn't miss much. But, yeah, Nick Foles was not really that good. But then all of a sudden, in the fourth quarter, turned it on. That magic Nick Foles again.
But, I mean, and people were saying this week, did the Cowboys win or did Seattle lose? And that's ridiculous. You can say that about the Bears-Eagles game with that field goal. But, I mean, the Cowboys definitely won that game last week. Yeah. I don't think they're getting the credit they deserve.
But yeah,
the Eagles and Saints, I think the Saints are going to mop the Eagles.
Really? Yeah. I can see that. I mean, well, the thing that they've got, the Eagles got going for them is that they got their butts whooped by the Saints like 48-something early in the season. And so, typically, I mean, if you know, you want to say like, okay, they got their butts whooped, they're going to get their butts whooped again. But typically what we see is that if someone gets their butts whooped, typically they come back and play them pretty tough because they got embarrassed. So that's going to be a good game to watch. In the AFC, we've got Chargers at Patriots. I think the Patriots are only like a 4-point favorite.
I'll take the Chargers in that game.
You know, the Chargers are a lot like the Cowboys. They're just, you know, a lot of hype. They got a good quarterback, you know, when we had Tony. And they just always kind of just fade out. And I actually picked them last week to win. And I still was surprised when they beat Baltimore. Their defense is really good, though, the Chargers.
Yeah.
I think that they could give – if they could get pressure on Brady, just like everybody, if you can get pressure on Brady, he's not the same quarterback.
Well, he hasn't been the same quarterback this season in general.
Yeah.
I mean, but that's talking about one of the best of all time to, you know, just a good quarterback this year. But still, it's a downgrading for him. So I think the Patriots are vulnerable right now. And I think the Chargers got the team to do it.
Yeah, it is in Foxborough, though, and they are pretty much unbeatable. I can only think of that Ravens game 7-8 years ago, and they just beat the crap out of them. But I'd have to probably go with the Pats if I was putting money on it. I just don't trust the Chargers. I see what you're saying, though. I mean, that's a sleeper pick for sure. I mean, the Chargers have got weapons on offense. They've got a really good defense. That's going to be an interesting matchup. And then the other one was Chiefs and who? Chiefs and I forgot who they're playing.
We're going to say, I don't know who the Chiefs are playing either. Well, I guess the Chiefs are winning that one.
Right.
Chiefs and Colts. The sleepy Colts.
God, man. These Colts are.
Those guys just keep hanging around.
Andrew Luck's playing really well.
Mm-hmm.
Man, they beat the crap out of Houston. I loved it.
Yeah.
Deshaun Watson looked like a different quarterback. You know, everyone was hyping up Houston. Everyone's hyping up the Colts too, but I mean, and then you got Andy Reid over there, and he loves nutting up in the playoffs. I think that that's going to be a I think that that might be – I don't know. You know, because I think the Colts' defense is really well, but I think I can just see the Chiefs, man. They've been mauling everybody this year.
Yeah. I mean, they've lost a couple big games that they shouldn't have lost, I don't think.
That's true.
I mean, they had the shootout with the Rams.
Yep.
They lost to the Pats early.
Mm-hmm.
But the Chiefs – I don't know. I think the Chiefs have a well-rounded team, and I think they're going to put it on the Colts.
Yeah, I mean, their defense is suspect, but I think they're getting some of their key guys back. They've got that weird defense like Sanders used to be back in the day. Not Dion, but Bob Sanders, whatever his name was, with the Colts. Remember the defense? They were just so much better when that one guy was in there. I think Barry, that's his name, for the Chiefs this year. I mean, he's coming back. So that'll be an interesting matchup to watch. I think that probably the Pats and Chiefs, and I think maybe the Chiefs, you know, will take care of business and beat the Patriots to make it to the Super Bowl, but we'll have to see.
Chiefs in the Super Bowl. That sounds ignorant.
It does, right? You know, it just doesn't sound like they but they would have the game at home, though. You know, they would be playing the Patriots and at home. So, yeah, cool. What else we got?
National championship game.
Oh, yes. National championship game.
The mighty SEC Falls.
Man, Troy Hudson, I am so sorry for you, but that was a beatdown.
That was terrible.
From the get-go, pick six. Now, Bama did come back and actually had a lead for a minute, and then they never – it was like a Clemson scored 30 in a row after that, 30 points unanswered. Just a beatdown. And I kept watching with Erica. Erica was on her playing her solitaire on her phone, and she's like, why are we watching this? I'm like, because Bama doesn't get blown out. Something's going to happen. They're going to come back. And about 2 minutes in the fourth, I was like, this game's over.
And yeah, Clemson, I mean, if you go back and rewatch the playoff games, you would think Clemson would – be coming out there firing, because they were firing against Notre Dame.
Yeah. I don't think Notre Dame was real, though. I think they get a lot of Cowboys. You know, we haven't been in the Super Bowl in however long. We ain't been in NFC Championship, but we still get talked about all the time. I think Notre Dame's they've lived on the history, because past two times they've got in a big game, they got blown out by Alabama a couple years ago in the national championship. And then, yeah, I mean, that wasn't even a game at the Cotton Bowl in Arlington. That was weak, but Clemson's got a good squad, I think. So now they've been in the playoffs 4 years in a row. They won, and then they lost to Bama, and then they actually won. So they play. Yeah, they've played Bama. They actually played them in the semifinals, I think, last year and lost. But for the national championship, Dabo is actually 2, and old Tricky Nicky is only 1. And I know that makes you happy, Colin.
Yeah. Yeah, Nick Saban's garbage player.
Plus, that gives what's it called? That gives the ACC some more credibility. They were talking about on the ticket that SEC has not won, or they, like, the past 8 years or so, they've only won a couple now. They're not, you know, I think they probably still are the best conference because of just how many teams are in there. But Clemson is,
I mean, for a while it was Florida won, then LSU won, then Florida won, then Bama won.
Yep.
And now it's going over to, I mean, because Florida State won.
Yep.
Clemson has
won twice.
Two.
Yep.
Georgia Tech won in 1990.
Indeed. And one of the things that I wanted to give a shout-out to Keege is that Georgia Tech actually put up more points against Clemson this year than Alabama did.
That's a fact.
Now, they also gave up more points, too,
though.
Yeah,
they gave
indeed,
up a lot of points.
Indeed. But I thought that was a funny note when I looked at the score. I'm like, oh, my God, they scored more points on Clemson than Alabama did.
Triple option, baby. Bye-bye, Paul Johnson.
Paul Johnson. Later.
R.I.P.
Who's their new coach? Do we even know?
I
know Keege is in their back pocket, whoever it is.
Yeah, Keege is paying for somebody. He's scouting people right now, I think.
To close this up, do we have any predictions on the Royal Rumble? I have not been keeping up at all. Who are they pushing right now?
Drew McIntyre's getting a big push. Finn Balor's actually getting a push again.
That's good to see.
I think the surprise entrance is going to be Kevin Owens, because he's been off TV for about 8 months now.
I haven't seen him in a while. You're right.
He's been hurt. I think he's going to come back in a... Sami Zayn also, but I don't think either one of them is going to win. I think it's going to be Bobby Lashley or Drew McIntyre who wins.
I'd say, since you said they're giving him a push, Finn Balor. You know, he got that Universal Championship, then he got hurt that same match, and so they hadn't been pushed ever since, though.
Well, me and Sherrod were talking about it the other night. They haven't put respect on that title since he lost, or since he got injured right after they debuted it. Because they gave it to Brock, they gave it to Roman, they gave it to Brock again, and...
Is Brock still champion?
Yeah.
Yeah, with Roman being out, I mean, who else are you going to give the belt to?
Yeah, well, Braun Strowman.
Oh, yeah?
Braun Strowman's fighting Lesnar for the title at the Royal Rumble.
Yeah. Boy, that'd be dope to see Lesnar F5 Strowman, though. Yeah. That'd be real nice.
It's going to be them two, then Sasha and Ronda.
Oh, okay. Ooh, that's going to be a good matchup.
And then Becky Lynch just won a triple threat match.
Okay.
Against Charlotte and Carmella to face Asuka.
Oh, okay. Asuka's champion. I didn't know that. Yeah. That is your girl.
Yeah.
She finally got the belt.
It was a triple threat between her, Charlotte, and Becky at TLC.
Gotcha.
First ever women's TLC. That was a great match. You need to go back and rewatch that.
Watch that, dude.
That was a great match.
Yeah, I was talking to Erica saying that it's about to be wrestling season. Because once the Royal Rumble hits, then we're on the road to WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be hanging out with Sherrod on that. Shout out to Sherrod Boyd. We'll have to get him on here one day to talk a little bit of wrestling.
Yeah, we'll do one during the Royal Rumble.
We should. That would be a lot of fun. In closing, want to definitely wish a happy birthday, number 59, for Linda Jackson.
Hey.
She actually was a little under the weather yesterday when I talked to her, which kind of sucks. She was sick on her birthday, but she's got a present coming to her. A red Blanton's t-shirt, and we got her a Blanton's candle.
Ooh,
yeah. She's going to love it. I like that t-shirt, too. It says something funny on it, but I forgot what it was. I told Erica I'm probably going to steal that from LJ. That's kind of a...
Yeah, and you are probably one of the only sons in America who steals clothes from their mother.
That's true, though. No, I've been known to do that. Now, mm-hmm. I do have a beautiful fiancé that dresses me really nice now, so there's mm-hmm. no need to steal from my mother. But yes, no... My mother would purchase men clothing, and I would definitely take the men clothing. So it's not like I was wearing girls' clothes and stuff like that.
Well, not in public.
Not in public. Only at the house with the family. Yep. All right. Well, hey, thanks for listening. We will catch you guys hopefully next week as we preview a Cowboys NFC Championship game. Keep your fingers crossed, and always remember, shout out to Moses. Ciao.
I guess briefly touch on what transpired with the Cowboys last week against the Rams. Not Rams, Seahawks. Damn it, I'm trying to drive and record at the same time. This is an abortion.